This problem involves vapor-liquid equilibrium calculation using fugacity coefficients. And fugacity coefficients for each fluid in this binary mixture are given here in the problem statement. And so we're to use those to basically determine the temperature at which the fluid is existing, such that it has a mole fraction of 30% in the liquid phase for component 1, 70% for component 2. And that's in equilibrium with some vapor at a pressure of 2 bar of pressure. And so we wanted to determine what that temperature is. And so this is a bubble temperature calculation. And it requires an iterative solution, but for this problem, we only have to show the first iteration, basically, and then provide some indication of how we'll continue to iterate in order to find a solution. For any vapor-liquid equilibrium calculation, we can basically say that the fugacity of each component in one phase, so the fugacity of component one in the vapor phase, is equal to the fugacity of component one in the liquid phase. All right, and so if we start replacing terms and we realize that we want to use a fugacity coefficient model, then we have the mole fraction of component 1 times the fugacity coefficient of component 1 times the pressure, that's the fugacity of the vapor, is equal to the mole fraction of component 1 in the liquid times the fugacity, and this should be vapor, times the fugacity of coefficient 1 in the liquid times the pressure is equal to the fugacity of the liquid. And so we see that we can simplify the equation right away by canceling the pressure terms. And we're furthermore told that the vapor phase is an ideal gas. And recall that for an ideal gas, the fugacity coefficient is 1. All right, and so now we have a somewhat simplified equation where we have a known fugacity, or known, excuse me, mole fraction in the liquid, and an expression for the fugacity coefficient in terms of temperature, and we're told to make some kind of initial guess. We'll begin by saying that Y1 is equal to 0.30. Then we simply need the fugacity coefficient term. And we should get an expression like the one that just appeared on your screen, where we've just taken this equation. We have a 1 plus 1.3 times x1, which is 0.3, 30% of component 1 in the liquid phase, times the exponential of t over 200. And we'll just guess, for an initial guess, 240 Kelvin. And in that case, y1 is equal to about 0.688. And now we can use the same expression as we have up here, but just with subscripted 2s. And so we can take y2 is equal to x2, which is equal to 0.7. And then we take the expression for the fugacity coefficient of component 2, which is right up here. So that's equal to 0.1 plus 0.2 times 0.7 again times the exponential t over 280 in this case. And this is equal to approximately 0.301. And now we see that the constraint that we have to meet in order to make our phase equilibrium hold is that the sum of yi, so y1 plus y2, should be equal to 100%, so it should be equal to 1. And we actually made a pretty good initial guess here that when we add 0.688 to 0.301, then we'll get 0.989, which is close to 1. And so we made a pretty good initial guess, as was indicated here, that it should be in the range between 230 and 280 Kelvin. Right, and we see that the mole fraction is summing up to be too low, which indicates that the partial pressures of the two components are being estimated as being lower than they actually are. So they should actually add up to 2 bar, and they add up to slightly less than that. And so that indicates that we don't have a high enough temperature to make the components as volatile as they actually are. And so we should increase the temperature in our next guess to something above 240 Kelvin as we iterate to try to find the solution for which the sum of y's is equal to 1. And when we achieve an acceptably close value to 1, then we're done with our iteration scheme.